Hello, my name is Hiroshi Yamazoe. This time, I'd like to talk about what I felt in the last time I went to climbing and camping in the mountain by myself. I was alone in the mountain and I thought many things in there. By the way, I have made already a video about that last time of my climbing and camping in the mountain. If you are interested, please take a look at it. And now, I will talk about what I felt during that trip. I had been staying in the Nagoya city couple of months due to the COVID-19. But I love nature and I wanted to be alone in nature. And request for the self-restraint to travel are partially released. So I went mountain climbing in Mie Prefecture. The mountain I climbed is called Fujiwara Dake. It was raining, but according to the weather forecast, it was raining lightly, so I don't mind it. I was planned to camp for 3 days while traversing the mountain. I had a minimal amount of gear with me, but my backpack came to 17 kilograms. I learned that climbing a mountain with a heavy backpack is a very hard activity. And when climbing a mountain, the slightest carelessness can be fatal. If you miss your footing or slip and fall, you could be seriously injured. You could even die because of it. There are also many dangers such as snakes, bears, landslides, and rock falls, and so on. Due to the such dangers a mountain has, my physical attention mode has changed while climbing the mountain. I should change the way I walk and how I move my viewpoint and how I put strength on my legs, and so on, to suit mountain pass condition. Otherwise, I may slip and get seriously injured. So I have to concentrate on climbing the mountain only to safely climb it. Through this, I felt that my mind and body were focused and matched only in the current situation. Now, the mind and body matched. It's a feeling I had forgotten while living in the city. And unlike the weather forecast, it rained heavily. I am having a hard time in this heavy rain. The water replaced jacket and shoes get soaked. The backpack that was said to be waterproof was also get soaked. The soaked backpack was much heavier. However, the mountains in the rain were mysterious and very beautiful. It was amazingly beautiful. There is no one around. I didn't meet anyone on the mountain pass. I am completely alone. I felt very calm in the rainy mountain. Then I arrived at the summit of Mount Fujiwara Dake. It takes about 4 hours from start point. So then I set up a tent on a gentle slope near the summit to avoid the wind. But as an amateur, I didn't sure how to make a tent. I managed to assemble it while reading the manual. I made a tent, however, because of the strong wind and rain. The wind and rain came in from a small gap in the tent. The wind was coming in and it was so cold that I couldn't sleep at night. Unlike the weather forecast, the rain and wind became stronger and stronger. In the news, a landslide warning was issued. It was a little scary, but at the same time, I felt some mysterious thing. It was very difficult to put this into words, but I will try it. Mountains are symbiotic space. trees and flowers and insects and birds use each other. For example, birds that eat plant seeds carry the seeds to another location. Insects make plants pollinate. Everything is connected while each other use each other. The rain plays an essential role in that connection in symbiotic space. Without rain, plants will not grow. So rain connects everything. I was listening to the sound of rain as I wrapped up in a sleeping bag in a cold tent. While hearing the sound of rain, my mind was dominated by strange ideas. If everything is connected by rain, maybe this rain part of God. I thought so. I may have been crazy, but I felt that way. If you were a resident of the forest, I think you would think so too. And I made a veiled attempt. The sound of rain hitting the ground may be a message from God. I thought so. So I was concentrating on the sound of rain to try to record the message of God. I thought it was some kind of message like Morse code. The rain that keeps everything connected and circulating. So they know everything and I feel like they can tell me everything. But I didn't understand any message. But I'm sure I felt a strange feeling that everything was in a match. Like everything became one. I felt that way. A feeling I have never felt in the city. If I stayed in the mountains for about a month alone, I had the feeling that my life might change dramatically. And morning has came. I was safe. However, because the equipment got wet, the camp was planned to be for 3 days originally, but I decided to return on this day. It became a camp for 2 days and one night, and I came back to city of Nagoya. By the way, there is a Buddhist practice called Shugendo in Japan since the old times. It is a practice method that aims to gain enlightenment by practicing in the stay in mountains for a long time. I only spent just 2 days, but I feel like I was able to understand just a little bit about the feelings of a person practicing Shugendo in the mountains. Also abroad, Christ and Muhammad have the experience of spending a long time in the wilderness and caves. This time I really felt that being alone in nature for a long period of time might be the key to gaining awareness, something that is difficult to obtain in everyday life. If my life has completely screwed up, I will try it. I will spend a month alone in the mountains. It might be changing my life, but it is very dangerous, so I would never recommend it to anyone. So my feeling about the last of my trip was like this. I'll be traveling to another place in this week, probably leaves around June 24th, and I make a video of the trip on YouTube also. So I will continue to post videos on YouTube more and more. If you are interested, please subscribe to my channel. So thank you for watching. See you and stay healthy. Goodbye.